taking over the game, one step at a time. Everybody has these dreams of being first in line. It may take a little while before we reach the light. We just gotta take what we got.
Happy December, everybody. It's still December, and I know Christmas is technically over, but I thought it'd be fun to review some holiday movies since I didn't really get to this year. I mean, I got to review Violent Night, but why not review some Christmas classics, movies that people can watch with their families around Christmas, such movies like It's a Wonderful Life, Charlie Brown Christmas, or Miracle on 34th Street, or whatever the fuck that's called. But we're gonna review possibly the greatest Christmas family film of all time, and that is Bad Santa. This is it. This is the family Christmas movie. In this film, we follow Willie, played by Billy Bob Thornton, who for the past 7 years has done this whole heist thing where he and his dwarf friend Marcus, played by Tony Cox, go to various malls around the world and dress up as Santa and an elf, and they entertain the kids, they act like Santa and an elf, and then on Christmas Day when the mall closes, they rob that very mall, and they do it every single year. But every year, Willie gets worse. More booze, more bullshit, more butt fucking. You know, the three B's, and it's just getting too much of a pain in the ass now. And while they're on their seventh heist, Willie befriends a very strange kid named Thurman Merman, and just barely, slowly starts to open up his heart just a little bit. Now, I'm gonna make this very clear before I review the rest of the movie. I'm specifically reviewing the unrated version, which I think is the most superior version of this film. The director's cut, it's complete bullshit. The way the director's cut ends is bullshit. I don't like the director's cut. The unrated version is far better in my opinion. And I'm not gonna do a whole comparison about what version did differently versus the other version. If you guys really wanna know, you could look it up online. I really don't feel like doing it. I might touch upon some scenes a little bit, but that's not really what I'm here for. I'm just here to review one of the best Christmas family movies ever made. Literally. I saw this movie when I was very young. My dad showed me this movie. My dad was pretty much responsible for showing me all these really raunchy and disgusting comedies that my mom would never approve of in the million years. And I've always loved Bad Santa. I watch it every year. It's one of my favorites. And I didn't want to just talk about this movie and just say all the funny quotes like, "Are you saying there's something wrong with my gear? Is that what you're saying?" "I'm sorry, your gear?" "My fuck stick. I am not gay." "The hell, buddy?" "Buddy! I said I am not gay." "Are you off your fucking meds or something?"
"Yes, but that is what this is about.
You're as quick as a $10 bill." "Well, let me tell you something, motherfucker. My brother lost a goddamn arm to you fighting you fuckers in Vietnam. Because I want you to look at me. I want you to look at my face one last fucking time. This is the last thing you're gonna see before I elf fucker." I didn't want this whole video to just be me quoting all my favorite quotes for the film or just talking about my favorite scenes. I really wanted to go in depth about this movie because I think this movie is special. On the surface, it is a very raunchy and nasty comedy, and Billy Bob Thornton is just this foul-mouthed asshole, but this movie is a lot deeper than most people think. This movie is very similar to a lot of Henry Chinowski stories, specifically the movie adaptations that were made on those stories, like Barfly with Mickey Rourke and Factotum with Matt Dillon. Both really great movies, by the way. This movie is very similar on those levels of a Henry Chinowski story, in the sense where our main character is a drunk, he's an asshole, and on the surface, he is a very dislikable character, and pretty much you don't want to really be around this character because he's disgusting, and he's the kind of person where you just want to get away from if you saw him in public. And that's what Billy Bob Thornton's character is. They don't pull away any punches. He's disgusting, he's a pervert, he's an asshole. He's just a horrible human being, but the script does a good job at making you like this character. And that also has to do with Billy Bob Thornton, who is actually really good in this movie. He's not just this raunchy asshole that likes to make smart-ass remarks. Billy Bob Thornton really does a lot with this character, and he is the best part about this entire film. Whenever Billy Bob Thornton is on the screen, he's chewing the fucking scenery. I mean, Billy Bob Thornton is such an underrated actor. Yeah, I know he is a very well-known actor. Most people know him, but I feel like he doesn't get enough credit for the movies that he's done, especially Sling Blade, which if you've never seen Sling Blade, then
you might want to order some taters and watch that movie. Mm-hmm. I reckon I might have to show me the biggins.
You can tell Billy Bob Thornton was really passionate about his role because he was specifically trying to make his character insanely dislikable and just a flat-out asshole, but for some reason, we enjoy seeing this character and we like him even though
The script is specifically telling us to hate this character, but we don't. Which is why I think the beginning of the unrated version is better, where it slowly goes into this bar and we just see Billy Bob Thornton wearing his Santa costume and he's just drinking a beer. And there's this whole narration where he's slowly kind of just talking about his life. Whereas in the director's cut, that entire narration is cut out. And I don't know why they did that, because the narration that Billy Bob Thornton did throughout that entire opening scene, it's so well done. And Billy Bob Thornton telling his story didn't just feel like this whole, like, oh, it's narration. They're trying to use exposition to tell his backstory, and it's kind of lazy. It means something. Whereas in the director's cut, you're just like, who the fuck is this guy? Like, why should I care? Billy Bob Thornton's narration in the unrated version makes it better. Surrounding Billy Bob Thornton in this movie are just some of the best comedic side characters that you would ever see in a comedy, starting off with Marcus, played by Tony Cox, who you might remember as Mr. Parker from Friday.
God damn devil!
You know, speaking of Friday, I just realized something. Friday and Bad Santa both have a scene where Tony Cox attacks Bernie Mac. Like, in Friday, he's chasing him down the street in his drawers, and then in Bad Santa, he hits him with the car. And then, of course, like I said, Bernie Mac, who plays as this mall security guard. Oh, come on, baby, give us some of that right there, yo. Yeah, yeah, that right there.
Half.
Half. I mean, the opening scene where we first meet Bernie Mac, where he's just taking that really long drag of a cigarette, always made me just go, how is this motherfucker not coughing? Even my fucking dad couldn't do anything like that. And then, of course, it all spins around to arguably the best character in this entire film, which is Thurman Merman, played by Brett Kelly. This kid is just hilarious. I mean, even his opening scene really just kind of gives the idea of this kid just being a loser when he gets off the bus and he's got all that snot lying down. Every time I watch the movie, I'm just like, ugh, like I just want to throw a fucking tissue in the screen for this kid to just wipe his fucking nose. Even Billy Bob Thornton at one point goes, what do you want for Christmas? A snot rag? Like, it just bugged me so much, especially when it's getting close to his lip. I'm just like, that is so fucking disgusting. But the camaraderie between Thurman Merman and Willie is just pitch perfect comedy.
What is it with you anyway? Somebody drop you on your fucking head?
On my head?
Well, yeah, what are they gonna drop you on somebody else's head?
How can they drop me onto my own head?
No, not onto your... what? God damn it! Are you fucking with me?
Even some of the small side characters who probably only get like maybe 2 or 5 minutes of screen time in the entire movie always leave an impact, especially John Ritter as Bob Chepeska.
Yesterday, I was in the women's section. I kept hearing, yeah, oh yeah. And I heard his voice, and I heard him say, that's right, you ain't gonna S-I-G-T right for a week.
And if you guys didn't know, this was John Ritter's last movie, which is such a shame. Rest in peace. I mean, I think my favorite performance of his was either from Sling Blade or when he was the police chief in Bride of Chucky. I mean, he's hilarious in that movie. And then another side character who I absolutely love, who's only in the movie for about maybe 45 seconds to a minute, is Octavia Spencer as this hooker named Opal. I mean, her line delivery is hilarious.
Screw you, Willie, you kinky ass. Last time I didn't shit right for a week.
It's really funny when you watch this movie and you see how far Octavia Spencer has gotten to playing this hooker to winning an Oscar for a movie. I mean, she's definitely made it big. And then, of course, how could I forget about the woman that I fell in love with? The woman that pretty much taught me how to get a boner. Lauren Graham as Sue, who plays as this bartender that slowly kind of falls in love with Billy Bob Thornton's character. She's so fucking sweet in this movie. I was in love with her. She was like the babysitter I always wanted, and specifically the kind of babysitter that I really wish would have molested me. Okay, maybe that was a little bit too far. What I do love about the unrated version more than I did from the director's cut is that Billy Bob Thornton's character is always trying to build Thurman Merman up to be like a man, like he needs to stick up for himself. Whereas in the director's cut, all he does is just tell him to stop being a pussy. There's never that really great moment where they're in the boxing ring and he's teaching him how to fight and he kicks Marcus in the balls. The director's cut, nowhere to be seen. And then even towards the ending where Thurman Merman actually finds out how to stand up for himself and kicks that bully in the balls, nowhere to be seen in the director's cut. That's why the unrated version is so much better, because there's such a beautiful and very funny character arc with Thurman Merman, whereas in the director's cut, towards the end, he's still kind of a loser. But in the unrated cut, they actually give him a purpose and make him not a loser. That's why the unrated version's better. So if you guys have never seen Bad Santa, watch the unrated version. Fuck the director's cut. It's not worth your time. And even besides all the really funny comedic scenes that has to do with Thurman, Merman, and Willie, what also really makes this movie so much special is some of the heartwarming scenes that these characters have, where specifically one scene where Thurman Merman builds Willie a wooden pickle and he accidentally cuts himself while making it for him, and then another scene where he asks him if he can get him a present even though he's a loser, and then Billy Bob Thornton just pretty much goes crazy and goes,
Jesus fucking Christ, kid! Why do you talk about yourself that way? Let me give you some news. I'm not Santa Claus, all right? Take a look at me. Do I look like Santa Claus? As a matter of fact, I'm living fucking proof that there's not a Santa Claus.
I know there's no Santa. I just thought maybe you want to give me a present because we're friends.
And it's just like, oh, come on. Bad Santa's actually making me feel something. Like, when is that ever going to happen again? Like, a movie like this would make you feel something. At this point, there really isn't much I can say about Bad Santa that hasn't been said already, other than the fact that it really is a smarter movie underneath the surface. Above the surface, people just look at it as this really stupid, over-the-top, raunchy comedy, but this movie is a lot more than what people say it is. I love Bad Santa. I've always loved this movie. I like to watch it every year, and I can't wait to watch it with my son when he gets older to understand this stuff. But in the end, Bad Santa is just great. So obviously, without a doubt, Bad Santa gets an A+. Guys, thank you so much as always for watching my reviews. Look forward to more coming soon, and I'll see you guys next time in the new video. Peace.
Taking over the game one step at a time. Everybody has these dreams of being first in line. It may take a little while before we reach the light. We just gotta take what we gotta, make sure that we make it right.